I'm going to show you how to make handwritten text using PowerDirector. It's time to get right. First, we'll create the text using PhotoDirector. We'll go to File, Import, and we'll select Photos. We'll go to the location on our machine where we have the photo. We'll left click the photo we want to use and we'll click on Open. Now for this, we want to have access to all the tools that we use. So we're going to click on Expert. And we're going to start off using the text tool. So we'll click on Text. And the font that we're going to use is called Sangharia. It's a free font that you can get from defont.com. So head on over and pick it up if you want to use it. We're going to change the size of our font to the size that we want for our text. And you can use whatever color you want to use. And we're going to make sure that it is on centered text. Now we'll click on the photo to add the text. And you'll see a text box will pop up. You can place your cursor over these dotted lines until you see a arrow and crosshairs. Hold down your left mouse and drag it so that you can see the entire text on the screen. You can click in a text box and type the text that you want to use. If you need to move it over, you can place your cursor over the lines again, hold down your left mouse, and drag it to where you want it to be. Now we'll create a mask of the text. You want to go over to your layers, and you want to left-click a layer, hold down your control key, and then left-click another layer until all of the layers are selected. Then you want to go up to the layer options, left-click that, and you want to go down to Merge and Merge Selected. Now you have one layer and you need to go ahead and select the letters and remove them. So we're going to go up here to the Selection tool. And we're going to go down to the Magic Wand and we'll left click on that. Then you can left click a letter and click the Delete button on your keyboard. And as you can see, it is now transparent because it had the checkerboard pattern behind it. You continue to do that with all of the letters. Left click and delete. Now we'll save the mask to use it in PowerDirector. We'll go to File. And we're going to go down to Export to PowerDirector. A message will pop up. We'll go ahead and select OK. Now you can see the text mask that we created is in the media room in PowerDirector. If you're finding this video useful, click that like button. It gives me an indication that I'm building an audience by creating helpful content for my viewers. Now we'll use PowerDirector to create the animation. We'll left click on the mask, hold down our left mouse button and drag it down to track 3. We'll go to Edit. Blending mode, and we're going to change it from normal to darken, and that should help hide any outline of the text. And then we'll close this out. Now we'll go to plugins, and we'll go to paint designer. We're going to select the pen tool, and we want to change the width to a width that will cover each line of text. For me, it's 28. For you, it might be something different. And then you can select whatever color you want. We're going to keep it on white. Now, you'll bring your cursor over the image and you'll see that it has a circle. This is going to be the size of the pen. What you want to do is trace the letters with the pen so that it creates an animation. So we'll hold on our left mouse button and we'll begin tracing. It doesn't matter how fast or how slow you do this because you can change the duration and the speed of the animation later on. Once you're done, click on OK. You give it a name. and click OK. And now you can see the animation has been created. It looks a little sloppy, but we're going to fix that up really quick. Go up to the animation that you created, hold down your left mouse button and drag it down to track 2. Next, we want to add the original background image without the text to the project. So we'll go to the media room. We'll go to file, import, and media files. We'll select the original background image and we'll click open. And I will go up to that image, hold down our left mouse button and drag it down to track 1. And now we'll play it and see what it looks like. If you want to create a mask to make a map animation, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.